This is Ron from Super 8 to Video. I'm going to show how to format an SD card and both full format and quick format so that it'll work in the Wolverine machines. It's very, very easy to format an SD card. The actual hard part is you gotta watch it. See this drive here? It has every Wolverine film I've copied since 2016 on it. It has all my YouTube videos that I put out since 2016. And if I think I'm formatting this card, but I'm really formatting this drive, in 1 minute I've gotten rid of years worth of work. So I'm going to really stress that. Make certain you're formatting the SD card and that it's the card you want to format, because they can all look alike. If you look here, there's like a little green sticker on it. I get those from, I use a Dvorak keyboard, which is easier to type on, but it scrambles the keys on the keyboard, so I have to mark them. And I always have extra little stickers. I'm talking about these stickers here, like this here. You just peel the stickers off, and I always put them on my USB connections so that I always know that side's up. And I just find it easier. As an example, this one here has it at that end and it has it at this end. That way I always know which way it goes in. It's just a little comment I'll make. Again, I'll leave an affiliate link. But what I want to really stress again is the fact that be very certain you're formatting the card and not some other drive on the computer. And so now I'm going to show you how to do that and how to be very certain. First thing is just unplug any external drive you have in there and set it aside. That way it's impossible for you to accidentally format this when you think you're formatting this. Next, make sure your SD card is unlocked by pushing this slider up. Otherwise it won't read and write. Then take your card and insert it into your card reader. Then what I do, I come here and I plug it in to the USB. You hear Windows acknowledge it. I come and hit the Windows E key. That brings up the File Explorer. Then I unplug it, literally. Just come here and physically unplug it. And you'll see it go away. Plug it back in. You'll see it reappear. That way I know for sure it's this drive that I want to format. Hover the mouse over the card you have been pulling in and out of the USB port. Right-click your SD card. Scroll down. Left-click Format. Check capacity. It should be the same or very close to the SD card size in gigabytes. Even though I have a 32 gigabyte card in my card reader, the capacity says 29.7 GB, which stands for gigabytes. This is close, and it is another check to make sure I am formatting the correct card. I am going to select my 2 terabyte drive, and when I select Format, notice how it says 1.81 TB. TB stands for terabyte. 1 terabyte is 1,000 gigabytes. It's a red flag. Ask yourself, why is the capacity so different from your SD card's capacity? If your capacity is dramatically different, it is because you have selected a different drive or partition and not your SD card. Just another check you're formatting what you think you are formatting. Remember earlier I was pulling in and out the card reader with the card in it? You usually wouldn't want to do that with SD cards, thumb drives, etc. I do it for simplicity. The worst that is going to happen is I will ruin my $8 card, and if I were to corrupt a file, the format would wipe that file anyway. I am going to eject my 2 terabyte card
properly, showing you how to unplug devices safely from the USB ports. Come down here to Show Hidden Icons arrow. Left single click it, select Safely Remove Hardware and Eject Media. Select the device you're going to eject. In my case, it is Eject Silicone Power. Left single click it, wait a few seconds, and it is now okay to remove your device or SD card if you selected it. You go through this process because if your SD card or other device you are about to remove is being written to, when you yank it out of the USB port, you can end up corrupting the device or some files on the device. But since SD cards are so cheap and formatting will erase any corrupted files anyway, I do not worry about it in this instance. Now, back to formatting the SD card. Left-click this arrow and then select FAT32 Default. If you have a 4GB card or less, you will have the option of FAT with no 32. Ignore FAT and select FAT32. FAT will work, but it is not as universally recognized by other devices as FAT32. Now, come down to Allocation Unit Size and left-click this arrow. On my system, when I select Default Allocation Size and the first two selections below it, all four machines bark Cluster Size Wrong, which is misspelled, or Cluster Size Wrong, depending on the machine. I found the last two, both the 32 kilobyte and 64 kilobyte worked on my Wolverine Movie Maker Pro. I called Wolverine's tech department and 32 kilobytes is the size they recommended. So select 32 kilobytes. Down here where it says volume label, you can name your card. You can only use 12 or less characters and no special characters are allowed. I will call my card reader Super 8. Make sure this Quick Format box is selected with a check mark. Left click Start. This brings up a warning box, and if you are sure, left single click OK because this is the point of no return. It really is that quick. The format happened in real time. We full format the card if we are having problems with it. Full formatting the SD card has the computer check the SD card sector by sector. And if it finds a bad sector, the computer tells the card to no longer write to that sector, which can fix some problems. On my computer, the full format process takes 30 minutes. So full formatting for our purposes of using the SD card in the Wolverine machines is almost never necessary and is just a waste of 30 minutes. But if for some reason the card is not working in your machine, you can try full formatting it and it may fix the issue. Full formatting does other things like erasing all the data on the card more thoroughly, but for our purposes, fixing the card is what matters. Now, I am going to full format the card. To full format a card, we do exactly the same selections under File System, FAT32, under Allocation Unit Size, 32 kilobytes, under Volume Label, name it what we want. Under Format Options, just uncheck the Quick Format box by left-clicking it. Unchecking the Quick Format box is the only difference made to change it from Quick Format to Full Format. Now, click Start. Up comes the warning box again. Click OK, In my case, a 32 gigabyte card takes 30 minutes. Your computer may take longer or shorter. I am going to fast forward the film so we do not wait 30 minutes. Close these windows down. Come down here and eject your card safely. Pull your card out of the USB port and it is now ready to be used in your machine.
This is my final warning. I don't care if you have to pull this guy in and out 10 times to be certain that's the device you're formatting, but just be very certain. I'm doing a playlist on SD cards right now, which is April in 2021, because they can really act up on the machines. If you're having trouble with the machine being jerky, meaning the films come out jerky and unstable, it's almost for sure the SD card, not the machine. So I've been doing a little bit of research and I settled on these cards, and I'm going to leave a affiliate link to them. But truthfully, I haven't tried them yet. If they do act up, I'll change the affiliate link. But hopefully these Lexar cards will do well. My next video is going to be totally about SD cards and what I've found out about them and the Wolverine machine. And in a few seconds, you're going to see the moon set. And you'll have some what YouTube calls in cards that you can click on. If you click on the card that will for sure be here when this video is out, it'll show you how to format a card on the Wolverine machine in 50 seconds. Hopefully, if you're watching this a little later, in a week or two, I'll have my video up totally about SD cards. And that'll be a card you can click on as well. This is Ron from Super 8 to Video, signing off. Oh,